Throw my hand one more time. I dare you.
Hey.
Hi.
How are you?
Hey,
big news.
Big news.
What? You can't freak out. I quit my job.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I did.
What?
Yeah, I quit my job.
Why are you laughing? Why'd you quit?
I just felt like it was time. Like, this whole thing's taking off. I'm like, you know what? Screw it. Like, I'm just going to quit.
Wait.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Why would you do that without talking to me?
But I don't know. Just like, you know what? I'm going in today. I walked right up to my boss and said, I'm done. Love you guys, but I can't. I'm done.
No, you did not, Michael.
Yeah.
No, you did not.
Let's do this thing full time.
We don't have any subscribers on YouTube. We have like 4,000. We can't do this full time yet. It's not time!
I'm starting Bae's nightly routine. He only likes 2.5 pieces of ice in his water, so here I am cutting one of the pieces of ice so that it's the perfect temp to him. I have to make sure it's perfect and to his liking. Next, I have to go in the other room and call his gamer friends to make sure that they're ready to game when he is.
Hello?
Hey, Alex, it's Amelia. Chad's going to be ready soon.
All right, for sure, bet.
Taking my slippers off before entering the bathroom was very important for him. I then turn on the shower and make sure it's at the perfect temperature for him. Not too hot, not too cold, but right in the middle. To keep his pearly whites, I wet the toothbrush and put 2 little droplets exactly where he wants them on his toothbrush and set it down. Lastly, I get Saint, his puppy, ready to be his emotional support during gaming. He made it really easy this time.
Saying you're no longer part of the TikTok creator fund. We're not going to let you earn any money off of anything anymore because you've had a violation, right? Can't appeal it because it's in the past, but they're going to strip the ability for me to make money off TikTok, which, I mean, let's be real, I wasn't making that much. For me, it's more about the principle of the matter. I'm bringing you millions and millions of views weekly, hundreds of users. I brought you an older demographic. That's what they originally brought me on TikTok for, and they paid me to bring an older demographic to TikTok, which I did. I've done nothing but create the content that they asked me to make, and now they're telling me they're not going to pay me to make this content.
So let me get this right, John Dawson. What I heard you say was TikTok paid me to make Rocket Raccoon content for an older demographic. And now that Rocket Raccoon content is not needed anymore, they're not paying you anymore. Is that about right? I can't make this shit up. That's how you got your blue check mark. Now I know.
Goofy alert, goofy alert. If you haven't heard of Oliver, he died from a stab wound in the neck Sunday. But guess who set it up? His girlfriend. She paid 4 people to help her kill him. She lured him out of his home, and when he got to the field, all of them jumped on him and he got stabbed in the neck. She even went private once she started getting all the hate. And this is the video she posted before she did the crime. Sad, bro. Young boys on the app, women can hurt you too, bro. So be careful out here.
your homie ain't shoot. Fuck say night for the flathead dude. I don't know what to say about Whitey. Been in the stool too long writing. This 51 dead ops. Hope I don't get indicted. Bitch.
Wait, did you think I was gonna make fun of a dead person? I would never do that.
Fuck your homie dead. Fuck your homie dead.
Is 5 inches big enough for you?
Okay, so actually the woman's cervix is about 4 to 5 inches deep, so 5 inches can actually do a lot. As long as you know how to use it and like you know how to work it, then yes, 5 inches would be good.
So you going deep and so
yeah, well let the men know like how like the cervix is or anything. So like women, like lots of women, not all women, are like if they're not 6 inches or above or 7 inches, some like extreme number, and like that's way too big for a woman's cervix, because the cervix it's only like 4 or 5 inches deep. So 4 or 5 inches, if you know how to use it and work it, then you're good. You're good.
Right, how about?
It's very rare to ever predict anything like this, but I think the Saints will go 0-16 next year. Now, I know it sounds crazy, but literally the Saints could win the award for the worst cap management in the league. Right, like just give them the goddamn trophy, bro. They are projected to be anywhere from $94 to $100 million over the cap limit. And even if Drew Brees retires, which he probably will, this is far from their worst contract, so it's not going to make much of a difference. Currently, the website overthecap.com projects the Saints to be right around $95 million over the cap, while the website SpotRack projects them to be right around $99 million over the cap. And even if they were to cut every player on the team, they would still be $38 million over the cap. However, if they were to cut, trade, and restructure players so that they save the money, they would get under the cap limit, but they would barely have enough players to field a team. So what's most likely to happen is the Saints will do whatever they can to actually have a playable team, and then the front office will have to probably do a combination of forfeiting draft picks and paying the rest out of pocket.
Looking at me, I know you wanna fuck me. I give you this dick if you lucky. Been a few days, I just want me some cutty.
I'ma
shoot at a nigga, no drip.
You ready?
What?
You ready for the next round?
I don't want to go then.
Why not?
I want to go home.
What you want to go home for?
I want to go home. My feet, you did something to my feet.
What'd I do?
I told you to stop because you kept going.
But what the hell happened to you? So you don't want to go no more because your feet cramping up?
I told you stop. I got some of my feet. I told you to stop.
Deontay.
Stop.
Ooh, what the hell happened to you? So come on, boy, stop playing. Let's go again.
I ain't doing no more. I don't want to do it no more with you.
Why not?
I don't want to.
Why?
It's very rare to ever predict anything like this, but I think the Saints will go 0-16 next year. Now, I know it sounds crazy, but literally the Saints could win the award for the worst cap management in the league. Right, like just give them the goddamn trophy, bro. They are projected to be anywhere from $94 to $100 million over the cap limit. And even if Drew Brees retires, which he probably will, this is far from their worst contract, so it's not going to make much of a difference. Currently, the website overthecap.com projects the Saints to be right around $95 million over the cap, while the website SpotRack projects them to be right around $99 million over the cap. And even if they were to cut every player on the team, they would still be $38 million over the cap. However, if they were to cut, trade, and restructure players so that they save the money, they would get under the cap limit, but they would barely have enough players to field a team. So what's most likely to happen is the Saints will do whatever they can to actually have a playable team, and then the front office will have to probably do a combination of forfeiting draft picks and paying the rest out of pocket.